Hello everyone, now let's see about the nature of quadratic form. This nature of quadratic form will come under the reduction of quadratic form to canonical form. In the university question papers, they will give the reduce the quadratic form to canonical form and then find the nature of the quadratic form and the nature of the roots. In the previous video itself, I have explained you about the reduction of quadratic form to canonical form. In this video, now let's see about nature of the quadratic form. First, the nature of the roots. There are three divisions: rank, index and signature. What is mean by rank? The number of eigenvalues positive, that is positive and negative eigenvalues of matrix A is called rank. The number of eigenvalues with a given matrix, we will find the characteristic equation. The characteristic equation will give you the eigenvalues. The number of eigenvalues will give you the rank of the matrix. Just consider an example. If the eigenvalues are 0, 1, 2, we will not take 0 into consideration. The remaining two values will give you the rank. The rank of this eigenvalues will be 2. And then next example, 0, 0, minus 1. Here the rank of the matrix will be 1. Take another set of eigenvalues, 1, minus 2, 0. Here the rank of the matrix will be 2. Consider both the positive and negative eigenvalues, just leave the zeros. And remaining, count the remaining numbers, you will get the rank of the matrix. Now the index of the quadratic form. The number of positive square terms in the canonical form is called the index of the quadratic form. After reducing the quadratic form to canonical form, we will get the square terms in this manner. They count the positive number of square terms, that will give you the index. Let us consider this example: x1 square minus 3x2 square plus 3x3 square. Here the number of positive terms, only two terms. X1 square is a positive square term. X3 square is a positive square term. So here the index of the quadratic form is 2. The next one, signature. The difference between the positive and the negative square terms is called the signature of the quadratic form. Already we have considered this equation. Now also we can take this one again. X2 square plus x3 square. Here the number of positive, difference between the positive and the negative square terms. The positive number of positive square term here is x1 square and x3 square, that is 1 and 2. 2 positive square terms, difference between, so we are putting minus inside, only 1 negative square term. You should not take the coefficient of the negative term. Just consider this is 1. 2 minus 1, you will get 1. 1 is the signature of the quadratic form. Then next, nature of the quadratic form. Nature of the quadratic form has the divisions positive definite, negative definite, and then positive semi-definite, negative semi-definite, and infinite. This positive definite, if all the eigenvalues of A are positive, then consider the eigenvalues 1, 1, 1. Here all the eigenvalues are positive. So the nature of this quadratic form is positive definite. Negative definite. If all the eigenvalues are negative, the given quadratic form is negative definite. Consider this minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. In these three eigenvalues, all the eigenvalues are negative. So we predict this nature as negative definite. Positive semi-definite. If all the eigenvalues of A are positive and only one eigenvalue is 0. Consider an example, 1, 1, 0. In this set of eigenvalues, two eigenvalues are positive and only one is 0. So we predict this nature as positive semi-definite. And next one, negative semi-definite. If all the eigenvalues are negative and only one eigenvalue is 0. Consider this example, minus 2, minus 3, comma 0. In this set of eigenvalues, 2 eigenvalue are negative and 1 is 0. So we predict this as negative semi-definite. What is indefinite? If A has both positive and negative eigenvalues, then the set of eigenvalues is said to be indefinite. Minus 1, 2, 3. In this eigenvalues, it has both negative as well as positive values. So, we call it as indefinite. Let us see an example. Reduce the quadratic form, given the equation, to canonical form by orthogonal transformation. Also, find the rank, index, signature and root of the quadratic form. The reduction of quadratic form I have already explained you in the previous video. Please look into it. Now let us see only how to find the rank, index, signature and nature of the quadratic form. I am writing the canonical form of equation directly. That is, after reducing the quadratic form, we will get this canonical form. The eigenvalues which we got, I have written here. Minus y1 square plus y2 square plus 4y3 square. First, we are going to find the rank. Rank, already I have told you what is rank. Number of positive and negative eigenvalues will give you the rank. Look at here, the positive and negative values 1, 2 and 3. We have 3 positive and negative values. So, we are rank, the rank of the quadratic form is 3. Need not take the numbers. Just consider this as first term, second and third. So, 3 eigenvalues. So, rank is 3. If we have 0 in the place of 4, we will write the rank as 2. But 3 of the eigenvalues or value, so I am writing as index. The number of positive square terms in the canonical form will give you the index. In the canonical form, the 3 terms are square terms and the number of positive terms is only 1 and 2. Here there is a negative sign, so this is a negative term, so we leave it and consider the remaining 2 terms. So we write as 2. Signature is the difference between the number of positive square terms and the negative square terms. Here the number of positive square term is 2. Negative term is only 1. So 2 minus 1 you will get 1. So I am writing the signature as 1. Nature of the quadratic form. Here the eigenvalues, both the negative and the positive values are there. So the nature of this quadratic form is indefinite. Hope you have understood. Thank you.